Hello, and welcome to the first video in our three-part series on using Garrisign to deploy a fast and secure code signing system. This video will provide an overview of Garrisign's code signing capabilities and demonstrate how to use some of its basic features. Instead of using a file upload approach of code signing that is slow and exposes unnecessary security risk, Garrisign uses client-side hashing, which results in high performance and a reduced attack surface. Let's see it in action. You're now looking at Garrisign's admin web interface, where you can manage keys, certificates, permissions, policies, and more. Here we see the cryptographic keys that are secured in our HSM. It is important to note that these keys are never exported from the HSM. Instead, clients can remotely request to use the keys to sign code and data. Let's say you're tasked with configuring the build server to sign code using a key in the HSM. This could be a CI/CD server, or one dedicated to production releases. To do this, you would copy the certificate's thumbprint from the Windows Certificate Store and use it in the signing command. Okay, that worked, but it wasn't very exciting. Let's say that this is the production key and should only be used once per quarter. The rest of the time, it must not be used. You would prevent usage of the key by disabling it from the Garrisign interface. Now, signing should fail. As expected, it failed. We're able to do this because we proxy access to the signing key instead of exporting it to the client. This enables just-in-time access where the key is disabled by default and only enabled when there's a need to use it. While I'm doing this from our web interface, these actions can also be triggered programmatically via Garrisign's APIs. For example, by your ticketing system once a ticket request is approved. Garrisign can also enforce other policies, such as multi-factor authentication, device authentication, approval workflows, and more, all with a few clicks from the admin interface. Suppose you wanted to enforce multi-factor authentication whenever you sign with your Mac production key. You would create a policy that requires multi-factor authentication if one didn't already exist. Then you attach the policy to the appropriate key. Now, when we run the signing command with our Mac signing key, the process hangs, and we are prompted to enter in multi-factor credentials. Garrisign supports a number of different multi-factor applications and protocols, so your organization can use what works best for its needs. Once we submit, the signing completes successfully. Garrisign supports signing other types of code as well, such as RPM and Debian packages, Java and Android applications, and more. Garrisign can also be used for other use cases, such as SSH, document signing, TLS, and more. We hope you enjoyed this basic introduction to Garrisign's code signing capabilities. Check out the next video in this series to learn more about Garrisign's advanced code signing features for automated signing in your CI/CD environment. Thanks for watching.